tonight on Wise Guy.
You played me like an old tune.
We'll do it again. You know what to listen for.
I have a new manager, Vinny Terranova.
You can't know how good it feels to be giving my mother this house.
Your deposit was returned against insufficient funds.
I'm not broke, am I?
The bloody thing bounced! It's that dumb move your wife made.
You hagged out Vegas bimbo. You're a piece of scum for what you did to me.
That's the music business, babe.
Nobody's got the pain anymore. Not like Billy. Words just flow like dark honey from her lips. This business stinks. Got the tradition in rhythm and blues. Got that. What have you got?
Synthesizers, crossover charts, plastic surgery.
You know, you're much too young to be so cynical.
I'm a realist. Mm. Isn't that why you married me?
I'm just a sucker for a pretty face. No, I married you for your brains and your smile. And because you believed in me. It was your drive that got Shakula out of the ghetto.
Well, let's hope your gambling habits haven't put us back there.
You know, there are worse things in life than being in the ghetto.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Name two.
Waking up next to Winston Nukwe.
Ew, there's a perverse thought. What's the second?
Waking up without you.
No, I won't let that happen. No matter where we end up.
You don't understand, baby. The feds have me nailed to the wall. This record return scam translates to tax evasion.
Isaac, You let your temper get the best of you.
Oh, no, Cushman, he deserved that beating. I mean, we had such a sweet deal going. I'd ship his retail chain LPs and CDs on the side, and then we'd split the extra cash. But he has the gall to shortchange me by billing me for some other label's returns.
Gee, how do you like that? There's just no honor amongst thieves anymore.
You're damn right. And now he's squawking to the FBI about our deal.
Isaac, this never would have happened if you hadn't have smacked him upside the head with his own walking stick.
Well, how was I supposed to know the law was trailing him? They're after him. Now he's giving them me?
So you give them somebody else.
What?
Take the immunity, Isaac.
Hey. I may be broke and going to jail, but I'm not going to flush my reputation down the toilet. That's all I got left. Turn Chatty Cathy for some federal snoops,
Isaac, Winston Nukwe would bore you an eighth orifice for a lot less. He's been trying to do it for years. He's the one they're after. Give him to them. I can't stand the idea of you being in prison.
You think looking at you from the other side of wire mesh grating is my idea of fun? Amber, I can't betray my friends.
He knows you're a gambling addict. He stole your livelihood in a card game. Now, where is the friendship there, Isaac?
You play the hand you're dealt. I live my life on that principle.
Then what am I supposed to do while you're sticking to your principles for 3 to 5? We'll mortgage the building. I mean, thank God we kept it in my name. And with the money, we'll start another company. We've done it before, but God, Isaac, you gotta come to Jesus, babe. You gotta stay out of jail.
There is no company to start. No artist, no ticket on the gravy train.
You'll find them. With the same instinct that got us here to begin with. You know what to listen for. We'll do it again.
I love your spirit.
And I love you. You gotta do this, baby. Do it for me.
Oh, he's gone, he left me, am I blue?
We're no closer to exposing Winston Newcray than we were months ago. I don't see that I'm getting much bang for the buck. What I see is your continued relationship with Bobby Travis, an innocent private citizen who's become attached to you at the hip.
Oh, Travis is on his own now. Well, he is, more or less. He's got his own contract with Radiance.
This is Winston and Claudia Newquay, owner of Radiance Recording, the largest privately owned company in the country. With no stockholders to answer to, Newquay is able to get away with more of the criminal practices in this business than he would a publicly accountable company.
I'm building a relationship with this guy.
Really?
Yeah.
Newquay distrusts you.
Well, yeah, he thinks I'm a hood smitten with show business. Some an amusing annoyance.
Another roadside attraction for the rock and roll bus. How long, if ever, before you're more than an amusement?
Paul, when Twine lost Shacklett and Newquay in a poker game, we got lucky. We got an opening. Newquay inherited Vince and Travis's contract with Shacklett. Whether Newquay likes it or not, Vinny's on the inside, and he's obligated to keep him there.
An office is not a case. Do we wait for another poker game to get lucky again?
That game was not luck, Paul. It was fixed.
Where's the proof? And even if you have it, so what? We are in the business of organized crime, not busting card games.
Paulbert Polly Ranfield runs the game in which Newquay bested Twine. Now, he was kicked out of Vegas in 82 for skimming a casino bank, never charged. The owners didn't want the publicity or the scrutiny. And he was tossed out of the Bahamas 3 years ago for running crooked gambling junkets.
He continues to run illegal card games for entertainment industry honchos and movers and shakers in Manhattan.
Where is this going?
Twine was involved in selling cleans. They're counterfeit CDs with the head of a retail chain, a guy by the name of Cushman.
Organized crime, Paul.
Cushman's ready to roll over on Twine because Twine beat his brains out for shortchanging him. We have Twine on assault, conspiracy to defraud, and tax evasion. He's nailed Paul, and he knows it. He's willing to turn state's evidence for immunity and give us Newquay.
He will, or he has?
Well, he's been stonewalling us.
The man has done hard time, Frank. What makes you think he'll talk? This operation cannot depend on a long shot, and that's all we've been going with. To top things off, Newquay's a power broker. His political connection should not be taken lightly.
Well, Paul, I am inside his business.
Having an office in his building does not make you a part of his business. He shut you out of the operation, hasn't he? Hasn't he?
Yes.
Then you better get the bleachers in this circus filled, or I'm folding the tent. There are businesses a lot less benign than the music industry that could use your attention. You're not getting through to Newquay. You're manipulating Bobby Travis. Neither of which makes me sanguine. That's all.
The biggest corporate honchos in the entertainment industry are 50 feet down the hall. And we've been denied access to the proceedings. I mean, what's the point in having a contract if it's not going to be honored, huh? Vinny? Earth to Vinny?
What?
I said, what's the point in having a contract if it's not going to be honored?
Well, that's the music business, babe.
Yeah. It's in there, Vince. I can feel it just down the hall. All that power passing us by. A full glass of greed, and we have to stay here and wait for the spillage. Where are you going?
To claim what's mine.
He doesn't want us in there.
I didn't say us. I said me. Bobby, I have an agenda with Winston that doesn't involve you. And it's in your best interest to stay clear of the spillage, okay?
My life's been on a roll with you, man. I don't know what you're talking about, but I'm not afraid of a little flack.
You know who I am, don't you?
I know that's your calling card, but you got heart, man. I've learned a lot working with you. Don't shut me out.
You've got your own contract with Radiant. You've got your own career here. We are not partners. Don't do that.
Haven't I helped you?
Yeah, we've helped each other. It's time for you to be on your own now.
Did the right thing to re-sign.
I didn't re-sign my contract. Shh, shh, shh. Contracts will never end with that stinking clause.
Yeah, hi. There's some weird guy down on the 15th floor going through the secretary's steps. You better get down there. Water, please. You're looking terrific, Claudia.
It's the one thing I do really well.
Thanks. Now you got self-effacement down to one art, too. And I know your key to Winston's success.
He'd never admit that.
Not publicly, maybe, but it is in writing.
What do you mean by that?
I've done some homework on Radiance. You own as much of this company as he does. Hold on to that thought. I'll be right back. I don't want you following me. I can't be responsible for you.
What's gotten into you?
Who's that guy with Eddie?
Now you want to talk.
Would you just tell me who he is?
Harvey Sticks, Major Money Management. Business manager, takes care of rock stars.
I want to get back in the studio, Winston.
Radiance needs you on tour.
I'm sick and tired of singing wet dream fantasies to children.
Well, they're the people who made you, Eddie.
My music made me. No more touring. I'm getting even on the albums I owe you, and then I'm out of here.
Excuse me.
He said kiss off, I think.
This is business, Claudia.
Half of which I own, Winston.
If you want to be anything more than you are, which is a notch above bar band, you'll listen to me.
I want to record.
And I say you're not ready. Your participation in this business is supposed to be silent.
Like your participation in our marriage? Not anymore, was it? No. I think I've finally found a way to make you pay attention to me.
Give me a ginger ale.
What's your problem?
I'm being raped. I didn't re-sign. I've got an additional album clause in my contract.
Typical deal on first contracts. Extend and suspend. He's got to deliver an album, what, every 12 months?
Every 6 months.
Ooh, that hurts. If he misses a delivery, he owes Radiance an additional album. If New Quake can keep him on the road for 6 months?
A year.
Instead of two albums, Eddie owes Winston four albums. And upon owing him four,
my contracts are automatically renewed at his option.
Don't you have a manager?
I fired him for making this deal. I was stupid to trust him. What was I supposed to do? 2 years ago, I was a naive kid looking for the big break. I'm a musician. What do I know about making deals? I'm stuck with Newquay for another 5 years.
Hey, you think? What's the matter with you?
Okay, hold it down.
Are you all right?
What do you care, man? Except that maybe I can't play.
Take your mutt and get out of here.
Hey, this is Radiant's business.
Well, it's not yours.
Now, look, Sammy. I am in this business to learn everything you know. And if you read the small print of my contract, that's exactly what it says. Full and total access to all aspects of the business that owns my contract, which is you. So you can take that little Lord Fauntleroy act and save it for the duration, because I am one member of this court you do not push around.
Come on, Eddie. Let's announce your re-signing. Let everyone know your hands. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, no speeches tonight. I just want to thank you for coming to this intimate party to celebrate the re-signing of Eddie Tempest to Radiance Recording. More importantly, his hand is just fine. But I'll let him tell you himself. Oh, I take complete responsibility for the cheap crystal. Make nice.
Yeah, my hand's all right. I'm really surprised to be here celebrating my new contract. Really surprised. And thrilled to be able to use this event to announce that I have a new manager. Mr. Vinny Terranova. Come on, let's hear it for him.
Now, I need the real thing, Leon. I need it bad.
I mean, no second choices here, man.
Oh, the boy's the best, man.
I need the heat, you know?
You're gonna love this kid, man. He's got something. Look at. He used to be in a gang called the Deads, right? Mm-hmm. But this one left, hit the streets, and started singing anti-gang raps.
Yeah, he's bad.
He's gonna rap himself right to the board.
Hold tight, yeah.
Standing on the corner just dropping dope lyrics. So come a little closer, make sure you hear it. Word from a brother trying to earn a little money. So help me out, folks, and a damn thing funny. I don't affiliate with gangs of cocaine, because cocaine pertains and change your stain the brain. But I will never tell you don't do cocaine, or show a picture of your brain frying like a chicken wing. Nah, that ain't my style. Not me and my crew. DJ Aladdin, Crazy Tune, Frank Scotty, you up to W. I think deeper, because life is too vital. Fuck a son of drugs, yo, yeah. It's suicidal. While you was wearing sweatsuits, Adidas, and gold, I was paying my dues, sleeping out in the cold, digging out a trash can, swapping people doing damage. The only meal I knew was potato chip sandwiches.
You're scratching that rhythm off of Anita Baker's beat, right?
You a lawyer or something?
Isaac Twyze is my name. Shakula Records. I wouldn't trust me either. You got a manager kid. I mean, we can make each other a lot of money. Come on, talk to me, son. I know you can talk, because I just heard the rap, huh? Look, I am in the music business. I need a guy like you, and you need a guy like me. Now, I'm not running a scam on you, but I'll tell you what I do. Okay? Six bills. No strings. Now, just don't blow it on no drugs, all right? Chill, give me a call, and we'll talk, all right? Damn.
What? Those two punks had bumped into us, you know?
You got boosted.
Couldn't have done it better myself.
Hold this, man.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Come on. Hey!
There. You gonna give me a call to what?
Hell yeah.
All right.
Yes.
I'll be calling you.
Yes.
You know, I came down here the other night and watched the sun come up. Come straight down the block like the street was built to it. Like...
The end of the rainbow, huh?
Yeah. You can't know how good it feels to be giving my mother this house. It's like so good, it's selfish. I want you to feel that way, because you're a good guy, Vinny.
Oh, thanks. Yeah, I do know that feeling.
You give your mom a house?
No. I told her the truth.
You know, I've been carrying that one check in my pocket for over a year, looking for the perfect place. Then when I wrote it, I felt religious. She never had anything to look at but industrial waste being dumped into the Ohio River. Then when we moved to the city, it was concrete.
Mr. Tempest?
Hey, Irene, how you doing? You got the key?
I'm terribly sorry, but your deposit was returned against insufficient funds.
What are you talking about? It's got to be some kind of mistake.
Yeah, I'm sure it is. Well, I'll try and keep the house off the market for a couple of days until you get things straightened out.
Did you tell Harvey you were writing a check on this house?
Nah, man. There's got to be some kind of mix up here. Oh, man, I can't believe this.
All right, just settle down. All right, we'll take care of it. We'll take a run over to money management and we'll get it all straightened out. Hey, you got a manager now, kid.
Come on, let's go.
Mr. Styx is out of the country, and without his approval, I can't give you those files. They're privileged client information.
Well, this is the privileged client. He doesn't need permission.
I'm sorry. Company policy.
Hey, listen to me, man. No policy's gonna keep me from buying a house for my mother. You got that?
Give him the files, David.
Mrs. Newquay, you know I can't do that.
Of course you can. I just told you to.
Oh, wow, you sound pretty natural giving orders.
Actually, I'm a little out of practice. My husband is the one who usually gets his way by intimidation.
Even with people he doesn't own?
Why don't we just call this my contribution to motherhood, shall we?
Thanks, Mrs. Newplay. I owe you one.
You're a great talent, Eddie. We want to keep you happy at Radiance. Now, if you have any other problems, you just give me a call.
Yeah, thanks a lot, pal.
But we're not partners, remember?
This has nothing to do with a business relationship, Bobby. I'm calling in a personal debt here.
But it doesn't look good for you to become a new...
Will you just quit screwing around and get to these printouts?
No, really, Vinny, I'm worried about your image. You don't want Winston Newquay to think you need a lowlife like me to understand what makes the music world go round.
Hey, come on, man. I don't know what frequency you guys are on, and I don't really care. I just want to find out what's in here. This isn't for Vinny, it's for me. Do it for me, okay?
It's gonna take some time.
All right.
Four limos to and from the beach, $1,000 an hour. What, you couldn't take a taxi?
Hey, they were waiting for us when we got to L.A.
$2,000 for hors d'oeuvres at the hotel.
What? I travel with a friggin' carnival.
Well, start checking everybody's noses, because that's where the money went. Up their noses.
Not me, not my band.
You know your last tour didn't even break even.
Come on, the houses were packed.
Your accounts with Radiance get charged back for every dime that caravan spends, Eddie.
What, Newquay forces me to tour? Then he makes me pay for it?
That's what the road's all about. And Radiance is not the World Bank.
Wait, Eddie. Doesn't Harvey send you a statement every month?
I make music, man. Harvey's supposed to handle all that.
Do you have any reason to trust him?
Yeah, Newquay gave him a seal of approval. All of Radiance's big acts leave their business to Harvey. Mm. No way, man. I'm not broke, am I?
Well, you're not broke, but you are on empty.
What about Eddie's last album that's going platinum? What about the royalties for that?
He wiped them out by taking a huge advance to pay Radiance back for the cost of the album he made before this one. Sorry, gents. It's one of life's little realities. The government calls it deficit reduction. Accountants call it an oxymoron.
Thank you.
Eddie. Play poker?
No. Why?
You got hustled.
Vinny, I don't know what to tell you. I tracked Harvey Sticks and Major Money Management as far as the Cayman Islands. Beyond that, it's a blizzard of shredded paper. There's nothing to tie Newquay to any of it.
Now, there's gotta be. It was too easy for Claudia Newquay to get into Eddie Tempest's file for. She was wielding more than client power.
Yeah, I get your drift. Now, Newquay is funneling his artists to Major Money and Sticks so they can drain the artist's assets into offshore accounts.
That's the way it looks in Eddie's financial statements.
Now, if we can tie Newquay to Major Money, we can get him on fraud, embezzlement, and tax evasion.
Yeah, but the only link that I have between him and Major Money is a $10,000 check to Paul Burt Ranfield.
Is that the guy that ran the card game where Twine lost his company to Newquay?
Yeah, that's the guy. Now, the check came out of Eddie's account, but he doesn't know anything about it. Or Paul Burt Ranfield, or poker, for that matter.
Well, maybe we'll pick Paul Burt up for questioning. We'll try out your theory about fleecing Twine.
Now, Badge isn't gonna scare this guy.
What? Are you thinking about friendly persuasion?
Yeah, very friendly. I'm gonna ask him if he wants to meet my relatives.
Blame me for your wife. I wasn't out of Heathrow when they had me back on the plane.
They should have thrown you out of the plane, you Burke. Look at this. Now, I've just authorized the transfer of funds from Major Money Management to Eddie Tempest.
You shouldn't do that.
I know that. For God's sake, I could be thrown in jail if my ownership position in this company was made public knowledge. But somebody had to do it. Because you let his account run dry.
Your problem is not the money. It's that dumb move your wife made, ordering my people to...
My wife can afford to be dumb. She has a bosom you could nest in. You, however, have nothing to rely on but your brains, which apparently have deserted you. Now, Eddie Tempest couldn't hold a debate with a doorstop. But he has a career that might be worth $200 million. He only cares about two things, his music and his mother. He has been carrying a single blank check in his pocket for over a year now. The one thing that he has asked of Major Money is to keep enough cash in his account so that he can write that check if he ever finds the perfect house for the little old lady. Well, Harvey, he wrote that check and the bloody thing bounced!
Oh, God.
I have devoted most of the day to salvaging this fiasco, which is why I was transferring funds.
Then it's okay.
No, it is not okay! Eddie Tempest may be a moron, but Vinnie Terranova isn't, and Vinnie has Eddie's books.
What is all the yelling about?
Claudia.
Sit down and shut up. Now, I want to know why Eddie's account is short the money.
I put it in that shopping mall you're building in Paramus.
You were getting on the next flight to Nassau and making sure that my fax authorization is destroyed and replaced by one of your own. Now, get out! You hagged out Vegas bimbo. Have you got any idea of the ramifications of your little prank?
What prank?
Authorizing the release of Eddie Tempest's books.
Well, they're his books, aren't they?
You stay out of my business or I swear to God I'll have you committed.
This is half my business, remember? And things are going to change around here now. I'm going to be involved in Radiance just the same way that Amber is involved with Isaac. They've got a much better marriage than we've got.
Amber is involved with the business every day. She's not out getting waxed. You are not going to be involved in this business because you have no idea how it works.
Then I'll find out how it works. I'll go write to a divorce attorney and find out exactly what my half of this company is worth. Bimbo my butt!
With a jackhammer.
Hey, Paulie. Come here.
Hey, Slick, what's up?
Newquay needs to see you right away. Come on.
What's the story?
So, Paulie, had to leave Vegas in kind of a hurry back in 82, didn't you? Hey, where you going?
What are you talking about?
That's all been squared away.
Squared away with who?
The old man, Debedino. Put something in my safe that makes me untouchable. What?
Well, I guess you didn't hear the news.
What news?
Old man Debedino's dead. Whatever you had on him, it doesn't pull any passes with his son.
Hey, where are we going? Penny. We can make a deal, right? Come on.
It was a cold deck. The dealer knew every card before it hit the table.
Oh, look where he played me like an old tune.
Yeah, it was Noogie. He's the one that's been setting you up for weeks.
What are you doing? Wait a minute. What are you
doing? Me.
Come on, you
company.
Can't put me in there.
Shut
wait
up.
A minute. Come on, give me a break. I said, shut up. If he doesn't give me back my company, I'm going to kill him with my bare hands.
Great, Isaac. Then you'll be up on a murder charge.
She's right, Isaac. Nukwe's got signed papers. It's going to be the testimony of one ripoff artist against another.
I want my company back.
There is a way.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I'm all ears.
All right. I'm inside Radiance, right? But Nukwe's keeping me at arm's length. Confront him about the card game. If you work out a deal with him, you can run Shakala under his banner. Together, we can find a way to take his company.
No, man, I cannot work for that bastard.
Well, what's the alternative?
I'll start another empire. I got the talent. I mean, have you heard my new rapper?
One rapper doesn't make an empire.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Okay, look, this is ridiculous. You guys are standing here hatching plans you can't possibly implement.
And why not?
Because you're about to go to jail, my darling. Okay?
Come on, man. Give me a break, will you?
Look, Vinnie might not like hearing this, but you're facing racketeering charges with the Justice Department. He's been offered immunity, and I want him to take it.
Now look, there is nothing about my life that they don't already know about. If he makes a good deal, I want him to take the immunity, too.
Wait a minute. Why are you so damn anxious to help us out?
Isaac, I was going places with you. I want to make some significant money in this business. The only person that's going to make any money at Radiance is Sir Winston. Come on, Isaac. Let's take him. I never believed in peerage anyway.
Me neither.
Right.
All right, you got a deal. America for the Americans, right, Vincenzo?
Yeah, right.
You know, Nukwe really came around. First thing this morning, he sends over a messenger with a cashier's check for the down payment on my mom's house. And a note apologizing.
What do you expect him to say? You caught me with my hand in the cookie jar, so here's just enough money to shut you up? Eddie, how stupid can you be? Isn't it obvious if Claudia Nukwe can release your books and Winston can write you checks that Major Money Management will make good on, that the Nukwes are controlling every dime you earn?
What am I supposed to do?
Quit being stupid.
Hey, quit calling me that.
Quit fitting the description. Rockers gotta grow up before they grow old. Now, I can get you an attorney to cancel your contract with Major Money. And you can learn to spend one day a month making sure you know where your money is.
You know, I work my tail off trying to give as good as I got to my music, and Nukwe steals my money and laughs at me. I'm gonna kill this son of a bitch.
Whoa, no, no, no. Eddie, wait a minute. Don't do anything nuts, okay? There's too much at stake here for you to blow it all by getting crazy. Where are you going?
I'm going for a walk.
All you gotta do, as I have said all along, is help us with our investigation of Nukwe. In return, we'll drop the assault charges against you and make sure that you're never prosecuted for any criminal activity that you took part in while operating Shackle Records.
Mr. McPike, we want that in writing.
I just want my company back.
Well, since you lost your company in a card game that was both crooked and illegal, I don't see any reason why Shackle shouldn't be restituted to you. Or at least that part of Shackle that wasn't involved in your illegal activities. As far as the related tax problem goes, I don't work that side of the street.
You are a hard man.
You should see me in my prime.
Well, Mr. McPike, before you leave, want to take out your badge and open up the liquor cabinet?
Keep him away from me.
Don't expect the feds to protect you, Palmer.
I'll give you everybody. I'll give you Debertino.
I'll give you all the players from Vegas. Names, numbers, anything you want.
What about Nukwe?
Oh, Fish, no problem. I'll give them to you on a platter.
All right, sports shoes, let's go.
Well, that goes the first ride off a Nukwe ship.
You stole our company. Isaac had a little heart-to-heart with your pal, Pulvert.
Though the papers have already been signed.
I could keep you tied up in court for years. Even with whatever proof you think you have. I can outspend you and outlast you.
Yeah, we know that. That's why I have a better proposition.
I'm listening.
Look, you don't need the litigation or the publicity. But you do need Isaac.
I've got Shakala. That's all I wanted.
Isaac is Shakala. He made it, built it, nurtured the talent. And without Isaac, Shakala's a stack of contracts. And without Shakala, Isaac's a broken man.
Nobody forced him to bet his life away.
Look, your black music division has consistently been your lowest grossing. Let Isaac run Shakala under the Radiance label. You'll have a successful company. Isaac will regain his dignity. And maybe if he's forced to work with somebody else, he'll become more responsible.
Well, it seems to me
that I've managed to confiscate everything of his, except his most valuable asset. Are we open to negotiations?
Don't flatter yourself.
Isaac's a luckier man than he thinks. Done.
Good. Well, I'll make lots of money.
How nice.
This is a business meeting.
Then I think I should be included.
Yes. Yes, I forgot.
I think there's a lot you've forgotten lately. I thought one of us ought to remember our anniversary today. Obviously, you didn't.
A day that will live in infamy.
Don't push me, Sammy.
Look, I'd better be going here.
Oh, no, 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 no. Stay. We're not shy about our family dramas. If you could manage to tear yourself away from pedicures and Cartier long enough to put in the hours and devotion to your alleged business interests, then maybe everybody would perceive you as more than just a dilettante. Your libido may be worth its weight in carrots, darling. But don't let's overdramatize.
You're brutal.
I pay for that right. Well, have Isaac come by my office.
It's been a novel experience talking to a woman who prefers acquiring capital to spending it.
How can you let him treat you this way?
Winston loves me. He just has a hard time showing it.
Claudia, you let this man treat you like a doormat. For money? You can't buy back your self-esteem with a credit card.
Do you think that you can get back on top by crawling under my husband? Don't think because we were friends for a long time, but I don't see what you're after.
Look what he's done to you.
Well, look what I've got. And you've got to go crawling and groveling to get a job for your husband.
I love my husband. And there's nothing I wouldn't do for him.
Obviously.
vodka. Neat.
Right?
No, I'm abstaining, Winston. I'm trying to cleanse my soul of the evils of temptation.
I hope you're not getting religious on me. Working with a born-again twine won't be much fun. We are cut from the same cloth, after all.
I'm a humbled man.
But still a greedy one, I hope.
Your phone call sounded so urgent, I was getting a little worried about you.
Well, you said if I had a problem, you could help.
Mm-hmm. What's the problem?
Your husband, he's ripping me off.
How's that?
I think your husband and Harvey Sticks have got a cushy deal going. They use major money management to take advantage of me and a lot of other people. Thanks. I know you're an integral part of Radiance. I think you know plenty. I would like some straight answers.
Actually, I'm Winston's partner. I'm a full partner.
Your husband's a thief. Maybe you're being ripped off, too.
No. No. It's worse than that. I'm being tolerated. Well, barely.
Yeah, I know. I've seen the way he treats you. I wouldn't let anybody treat my woman like that.
Winston, if you just leave me alone and let me do what I do best, I'd have a better chance of success than I did at that so-called poker game.
Water under the bridge, Isaac. You're a filthy, lying, slimy piece of scum for what you did to me. I'd like to cut you wide and deep and feed you the tender parts till you choke. Just had to get that off my chest.
I understand. Radiance will give you a much higher profile in the business than you ever had on your own. Now, why don't we call Billboard and tell them what tomorrow's headline is?
What's the matter, second thoughts?
Oh, no, not at all. I just forgot a very important appointment. Make yourself at home.
You, Jesus!
Step on it, I'm in a hurry.
What have you been up to?
Hello. There's been an accident. We need an ambulance.
I never thought I'd be happy doing business with you guys.
All right, I call the shots, no debate. You have any problem with that, we call it off right now.
I just want my company back and not go to jail.
Yeah, the latter being the more important.
All right, your activities inside Radiance will be fully monitored. If you're compromised in any fashion, I'm pulling you out for your own protection.
And if you do, does the deal still stand?
I need Nukwe.
Now, that's not an answer to my question.
Listen, you don't have a lot of options here.
The hell I don't.
I'd just soon go to jail as go through this game and not get my company back.
You will play the hand you dealt.
You talking to me about gambling? All right, come on. I will cut you for it.
You got a deal. I never win at those things.
And you think I do?
I hadn't told him he's just another dumb rocker. Got him all upset about his money and new Quay. Poor kid.
Bobby, you're not responsible. I just believed in living true to his gut. That's what made his music so great.
Glad you saw she got the house.
Yeah, I made sure Radiance paid for it out of Eddie's insurance policy with him.
You know what Twine told me new Quay said? Between what Claudia spent and what he made on Eddie's death, he figured he broke even. Can you believe it?
You can't know how good it feels to be giving my mother this house.
Next on Wise Guy.
New Quay took out a restraining order.
You are to vacate these premises and are barred from all...
Same to you, pal. This is a cease and desist order, which means you have to show cause to have us evicted.
You are to vacate the building.
I'm here for the duration.
I need to know everything about a man called Vincent Terranova.
He went after me and he got me. I might as well take a cab downtown and shoot him, because that's the only way I'm going to feel safe.
You owe me $8 million.
I'm sorry.
So what?
But I'm going to have to shoot you.